Hello children, this is Manish Yadav and today I am going to start a new chapter for class 11th. This is from the book of Hornbill, 5th chapter, The Ailing Planet, The Green Moment's Role. This chapter has been narrated by Nani Palkhivala. In this chapter, Nani Palkhivala writes about the green moment in 1972. She describes this article and published in the Indian Express on 24th of November 1994. This chapter raises the issues regarding the declining health of our planet, where we stay and live. This is the Earth. It is continuously having relevance and destructions in it. Most of the time, human beings are the causes and reasons to decline the health of this planet. We do not care of it as much as we ought to. We, as well as millions of creatures, share this planet. We are the consumers of our earth. In this chapter, Nani Palkhivala describes what was the impact and imagination, as well as holistic and ecological view of the earth. She describes about the green movement, which was expanded in 1972, and it took place in 1972. Since that moment, it did not come back or looked back. Let you know and go through the paragraphs and text. As the very beginning of the chapter, something has been given. The following article was written by Nani Palkhivala and published in the Indian Express on 24th November 1994. The issues that he raised regarding the declining health of the earth continue to have relevance. It is about the chapter. This following article has been written by Nani Palkhivala. As I have already told you, she is the writer, and this article had been published in the magazine of Indian Express on 24th November 1994. The issues, as I told you, this chapter raises the issues regarding the declining health of this planet, the earth, where we stay and live. And it is continuously having relevance and destructions in it. Let you go through the first paragraph of this chapter. And before starting the paragraph, I suggest all the students to be focused and attentive where I am reading out. Line by line, I'll explain. One cannot recall any moment in world history which has gripped the imagination of the entire human race so completely and so rapidly as the green moment, which started nearly 25 years ago. Nobody could recall any moment in the world history which has gripped the imagination of entire human race so completely and so rapidly. It is the green movement, which started nearly 25 years ago. Green movement was started and laid before 25 years ago, and nobody could recall any other movement except this movement, because it gripped and took a great place of the imagination of entire human race so completely. It gripped and took place in the mind as well as thinking as a glance upon the mind of human being. It left an imprint on the imagination of entire human race. It was started before 25 years ago. Next is, in 1972, the world's first nationwide Green Party was founded in New Zealand. Since then, the movement has not looked back. It took place first time in 1972, Nationwide Green Party. This party was founded in New Zealand. Since then, the movement has not looked back. It did not looked back since 1972 to today. We have shifted one hopes irrevocably from the mechanistic view to a holistic and ecological view of the world. Here the phrase that has been highlighted in the paragraph, a holistic and ecological view. It means our earth must be holy as well as its ecological development must be there if we are staying and sharing this planet. We are most intelligent rather than all the animals and creatures who share this planet along with us. So we must be responsible for its holistic and ecological view. I am talking about the planet, this earth. We are responsible and we must think about its holiness as well as ecology. It is a shift in human perceptions and revolutionary as that introduced by Copernicus, who taught mankind in 16th century that the earth and the other planets revolved around the sun. This happened first time in the history. Nobody knew that a planet, all the planets like Earth, Yam, Bud, and all in the solar system, they revolve around the sun. It was unknown. This process was unknown before 16th century. Nobody knows that all the planets revolve around the sun. But it was introduced. This information was introduced by Copernicus, who taught all the humans and mankind in 16th century that Earth and other planets revolve around the sun. Next line, for the first time in human history, there is a growing worldwide consciousness that the Earth itself is a living organism. It happened first time in the human history. There is a growing worldwide consciousness. It was an awareness for all the human beings in the world that the earth itself is a living organism, because it moves, it rotates the sun, it revolves around the sun, so that it is a moving, okay? It is a moving planet, so it is a living organism, an enormous being of which we are parts of. And this is a tremendous, tremendous planet that we are part of it. It has its own metabolic needs, and vital processes which need to be respected and preserved. This is a tremendous and large planet in the solar system. It has its own metabolic needs and processes, vital processes, metabolic, just you can say fundamental needs, okay, to recover its wounds and all the vital processes which need to be respected and preserved. And we human being are responsible and just respectable as well as just you can say we have to give all the replies and preserve about its metabolic needs and vital processes, because we are most intelligent creature and human being who share the planet together. The Earth's vital signs reveal a patient in declining health. Vital signs, those signs which shows the disturbance in the natural processes and the nature which is not beneficial for the universe. So we must think and respect as well as preserve its need as well as vital processes. The Earth vital signs. These signs reveal and shows glimpses or premonitize a patient in declining health. If something is going on to be disbalanced on the Earth, we must think it is declining health of this planet. We have begun to realize our ethical obligations to be a good stewards of the planet and responsible trustees of the legacy to future generations. We have begun to realize, we started realize and guess our ethical obligations. What must be the gratitude of human being towards the planet to be a good stewards of the planet and responsible trustees? We must be responsible trustees as well as a great responsibilities must be taken by all the human being, because it is the legacy, property to all the future generations and upcoming generations. If we are preserving the planet today itself, it must be useful and beneficial for all the upcoming generations in the future time. We are investing as well as depositing the legacy for our future generations if we save, preserve, as well as look after and take care of the Earth. So it would be legacy and property, fixed deposit for all the upcoming generations. The concept of sustainable development was popularized in 1987 by the World Commission on Environment and Development. The concept of sustainable development, this phrase has been highlighted with the black color. Sustainable development means that kind of development which is developed and proceeded without compromising the development and needs of future generation. So that kind of sustainable development must be there, which must be beneficial and useful for all the upcoming generations, our children. This development was popularized and advertised, published in 1987 by the World Commission on Environment and Development. Students must know the meaning of highlighted phrases in the paragraphs sustainable development, and there was another highlighted phrase, that is a holistic and ecological view. Again, I want to give the explanation for these phrases. A holistic and ecological view means a holy, okay, the Earth must be holy and its ecological state must be strong. And second highlighted phrase is sustainable development. This is a kind of development which is actioned without compromising the development as well as needs of upcoming generation. This development was popularized in 1987, and it was popularized by World Commission on Environment and Development. In its report, what was the definition according to the report of this commission? It defined the idea as development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their own needs and expectations. Just the description about the highlighted phrase sustainable development has been given in this paragraph. That is, it defines as the ideas that development meets the needs of the present as well as the needs of future generations and their abilities, okay, to meet their own needs. Okay, we have to develop this planet. We have to do our action as if it must be useful and able to connect all the future generations to their needs. Example, without stripping the natural world of resources future generations would need. Means we should not destroy the resources which is the need of our future generations. We have not to strip the needs and resources that is dangerous as well as risky for all the humans upcoming generation. In the zoo at Lusaka, Zambia, there is a case, their children, we must be focused through the text where I am reading out line by line. I am in the third paragraph of this chapter. In the zoo at Lusaka, Zambia, there is a case where the notice reads the world's most dangerous animal. Inside the case there is no animal but a mirror where you see yourself. There is a zoo at Lusaka. Lusaka is the name of a place. Zambia, it is situated in Zambia. There is a case where a notice reads. There is a notice, okay, at the top of the case, and it reads the world's most dangerous animal. Inside the case, there is no animal but a mirror. But there is no animal inside the case. What would you see over there? You will see inside a case mirror, okay, no animal, where you see yourself. Means when you will go before the case, you will see yourself in the mirror. It means when you see yourself in the mirror and the sign reads at the case world's most dangerous animal, it means you are the most dangerous animal. All the human beings, one by one, if they go before the mirror, they would see themselves in the mirror. So one by one, everybody has to know that human being is the most dangerous animal of the world. Thanks to the efforts of a number of agencies in different countries, as a new awareness has now dawned upon the most dangerous animal in the world. All the human beings, we human beings are most dangerous animal, and this was a great and new awareness that has dawned upon the all the human beings in the world. So if we would be aware of it, we could preserve and respect this planet. We could preserve it for our upcoming generation. He has realized the wisdom of shifting from a system based on domination to one based on partnership. We must be a partner and assistant to each other. We must shift this planet as the partnership, not as the domination. It must not be the based on domination to one based on partnership. Scientists have cataloged about 1.4 million living species with which mankind shares the earth. On the basis of informations provided by scientists, they have cataloged or listed, calculated about 1.4 million living species which mankind shares the earth. Including human being, there are 1.4 million of living species stay on the earth. Estimates vary widely as regards the still uncatalogued living species. And according to the estimate of scientists, there are unlisted and uncalculated living species also there. Biologists reckon that about 300 to 100 million other living species still languish unnamed. They are hidden, concealed, unnamed, unconscious, unknown, in ignominious darkness. Unknown darkness means the place where nobody could reach and approach to collect informations and to know about rest of the living species on the earth. That's it for this video. Remaining portion would be covering in the next video. Keep learning.